Hi guys, welcome to Lengsa YouTube channel. My name is Ram Mishra and I'm your online instructor. So what's new in this video? In this video, I will tell you how to work with Ansible magic variables. So guys, let's begin the topic. But before start the lab session, we have to understand few points, which is what is Ansible magic variable and their use cases. So for the demonstration purpose, I have a lab scenario for you. Please look at that. Guys, this is my Ansible magic variable lab setup environment. So the first point come in our mind is what is magic variable? So for sometimes it is called magic variable, sometimes it is called special variable. So these are the notifies and it is not configured as custom facts, but it is automatically set by the Ansible and we can use these variable inside playbook during the play. So for better understand, I explain this then in a simple term. We have looked at user defined variable as well as system data, that is facts. In addition to these, there are a few variables that define the meta information about the nodes, inventories and plays. For example, which groups a node belongs to, what groups are a part of the inventory file, which nodes belong to which groups and so on. These variables which are implicitly set are called magic variables and are very useful for discovering nodes and topology informations. So there are too many special variables are available in the Ansible, but it won't be possible to go over each, but I would be covering the couple of important ones so you would get the fair idea how to use these in your playbooks. Okay, so for this in my lab's environment, I have three tested virtual machine. This is my first virtual machine acting as a control node, and with the host name is server1.example.com, IP address is 192.168.0.1 and running Linux OS is RHEL 8.0. Even the Ansible is already installed in this machine with the current version is 2.9.1. Okay, and my another machine acting as a managed host, which is station1.example.com, IP address is 192.168.2 with the running OS is RHEL 8.0, and the second machine, or you can say go with the third machine, also known as the managed host, name station12.example.com, IP address is 192.168.3 and the running OS is RHEL 8.0. okay, so this is a small lab scenario I have created for you. So in this demo session, what I'm going to do, I'll make a playbook on control node with the magic variable. Here I just make a playbook with the magic variable and then I'll deploy it for the manage host. But remember, for deploying your playbook, your Ansible inventory file and the Ansible configuration file should be properly configured. So let's move to the lab session and create a playbook with the Ansible magic variable. Okay, so I just close this file for you and look at that. I am on the control node and this is my Linux terminal, and first of all I will show you the host name and the Ansible version. So the command is hostname ctl. See, the machine name is server1.example.com and currently I am using Red Hat Enterprise Linux 8.0, and if I am talking about the IP address, the current IP is on this machine is 192.168.0.1, and let's talk about the Ansible version. So I go with the command Ansible Ansible hyphen hyphen version. Yeah, version is 2.9.1. Okay, so I'll go to my project directory where I have my ansible.configuration file and inventory file. So I move to my project directory, and if I go with ls command, see, look at that. Here we have a configuration file as well as the inventory file. So I open my inventory file with cat command. See, this is my inventory file where I have mentioned two different groups with attached managed host. First group name is a web server with two nodes, station1.example.com, station2.example.com, and the second one is the mail server with the station1.example.com. And we can see that station 1 is a member of both available groups, web server as well as the mail server. Okay, so I start to make a playbook file. Name could be anything, but the extension should be .yaml because the Ansible playbook is a YAML script. Okay, so I started with the sign and name first.yaml. Okay, name could be anything as per your need. Started with 3-, go to the insert mode, 3-, and then now on the next line, after started new list, hash, and say assign a nice play name first. So in my case, I'm using play one. I define a play name, it could be anything, but in my case I'm using play one, and then I define the target section. So in the target section, I go with the host, and host parameter indicate which host you want to run this operation on. So I set all available host. Okay, there is no hard rule. Use all the hosts defined in the inventory file. We can choose one or multiple or group or multiple groups from the inventory file in the play. Then I define my task section. So I go with task. Okay, and I started with the task name. So I go with the name. Assign a nice name, could be anything with the nice description. So I say show host name using magic variable. Okay, fine. And for printing purpose, I use debug command. Debug. Then I say message. So available node is, and I use one magic variable. Start with my first magic variable, that is inventory. Host name. Okay, and for end the playbook type 3 dot. See what I did in this playbook. I just mentioned my first magic variable, which is inventory underscore host name. So it will return the host name of my managed nodes as list in your default host file or your own inventory file. It is very useful when you are debugging some failure in your plays. You would know that on which particular node play has failed. So using this, we can also verify which node is running now. It will show me the information. Okay, so finally, once we have successfully built the playbook, the points come how to run it. But before run the playbook, we have to check the syntax error of this YAML file. So the command is save and quit from there. And the command is ansible playbook --syntax-check and your playbook name, that is first.yml. Let's see what happened. Okay, looks good, no error. Now finally run the playbook and grab the result. So for run the playbook, just simply run the command ansible playbook and your YAML file. See, first of all, it shows my play name, that is play one, and then it getting some facts from manage host, that is station1.example.com. Okay, seems something wrong. Oh, look at that, spelling mistake. So once more time I have to open. Sorry, small typo error. Host name. Okay, run one more time. Again gathering some facts, station1.example.com, station2.example.com, and finally I got the result, which is two nodes are in running condition. Available node is station1.example.com as well as station2.example.com. So this magic variable checking from my inventory file and filtered the output which node is running now. So this is the one of the example. Okay, so let's take another example of magic variable. So I copy this YAML file and paste it with different name in the same location for my another playbook. So I just copy cp first playbook to second YAML file. Okay, so this time I just opened my second.yaml file. First of all, I modify the play name. So I go with say play 2. Okay, and assign the task name, define the task name. So this time I say show group name. Earlier I use host name, now this time I show group name using magic variable. And for this I use new magic variable, that is the member of instead of inventory hyphen host name, say group underscore names. save it. Okay, so here I use group underscore names. This will show the list of groups that the nodes belongs to. Okay, so just save and quit from here and again run this playbook. Second.yml. Show the play name, play 2, gathering facts, form station 1, station 2, and look at that. Look at that. Station 1 is the member of, it's clearly show me that station 1 is the member of mail server as well as web server, and station 2 is the member of web server group. Okay, so this is how we can take the help from groups underscore names magic variable. Now take another example of magic variable. So again, I just copy the playbook with different name. Just take that example. So I open my third.yml file. First of all, modify the play name. This is my third play. Okay, and this time instead of host all, I want to set this play runs only on station1.example.com. So what I have to do, just remove this one, station1.example.com, save it. Okay, and modifying the task name section also. So I say demonstration of, just remove this one, demo of host vars, very very important magic variable. Okay, and debug message, remove this one and just only save, only type host vars, save it. Okay, so see what happened when I execute this command and when I run this playbook. And let's take the example of hostvar. So here I use another magic variable, which is hostvar. This variable will print the OR variable related to this host. Okay, so let's save and quit from here and try to execute it. Say third.yml. Play third, gathering some facts. Okay, look at that, the large output. Look at that, all are the variables with their values from all nodes. From station1.example.com. Because see, we have all variable information which related to the host, because enable facts also the part of the host and it will print everything. So we have the option, we can disable the facts also. So I just open the file one more time, and here I just said gather underscore facts say false. Okay, now execute playbook one more time, let's see what happened. Looks good. See, okay, so here is the output of this one. So now I'll show you the magic of host var special variable in another terms. So I just modify my playbook again one more time and let's see what I'm going to do that. So I'll open one more time tell.ml and I say host var host vars and say station 2.example.com and just save it. Okay, see what I did, I just run this playbook only on station1.example.com. see here I only mentioned station1.example.com, not to all node, and I'm fetching all variable information from station2.example.com which are available to us. So this is the you can say the kind of magic of host var magic variable. So let's see what happened when I execute it. First of all, I'll execute this playbook. See, let me check the host where's, okay, session 2.ex, ex and spelling mistake, example, sample.com. okay, now save and quit and run one more time. See, look at that, I got the result. Okay, so here you can see that it display all the variable information from station 2.example.com which are available to us. All these things are available for us, we can use it as a variable format and we can use any of these variable. So let's print some variable output from the station 2. So what I did, I just copy the inventory underscore host name short, this one. I want to print the output of only this variable. So how can I do that? I just to copy it and modifying debug line one more time. So I just open one more brace and paste it here, save. Okay, now let's see what happened when I execute one more time. So I just grep the output of only this variable. Look at that, I got it. See, so now you can see this time I getting the information of only this variable from node 2, or you can say station 2.example.com. so if I open my YAML file, look at that. Okay, so this is how you can grab the information from another host to your current host, and this is why magic variable are very useful when you start writing complex kind of playbooks. So guys, this is how we can use magic variable in our playbook and deploy it over the network. And finally, this is the end of this topic also. Hopefully you enjoyed and learned new things. Soon I will come up with another new interesting topic. Till then, keep practicing. If you feel something I have missed or you wanted to know more something else, please leave your comment and subscribe my YouTube channel for more updates. And if you like this video, please do not forget to like, share and subscribe my channel and press the bell icon button for the latest update. Thanks for watching. Stay safe and goodbye.